I'm going to share something with y'all that might put me in a very negative light, yeah.
Relationships are not my forte.
See if someone grabbed up my wife or something, completely different ballgame.
I'll walk away from it and this has been like a therapy session.
Oscar Bevis, IFL TV, proudly sponsored by Everlast. My first interview of 2023, and of course I had to make it. Man himself, Mark Nielsen. Good to see you, Mark. How are you, mate?
Yeah, very well, thanks, mate, and Happy New Year to you. Honoured to be the first of the year.
Happy New Year to yourself, and yeah, my pleasure. So we'll jump straight in. Unlike last year with the British broadband, we're just a couple of weeks out from the first show, Chris Eubank and Liam Smith. Are you kind of just excited to get back to it? Obviously, I know you spoke to me a couple of days ago. You've been on holiday, so just kind of now ready to get back to it and knuckle down.
Yeah, I mean, doesn't it? COVID seems a distant memory now. If you think a year ago, there was still lockdowns and restrictions and everything. And, you know, we've just gone full throttle throughout the rest of 2022. It was, like I said, a distant memory now. So, you know, even though I've been on holiday, I think Christmas Day was the only day that matching wasn't done. There was still some matchmaking being done all around it. You know, I'm up a mountain skiing somewhere, my phone's pinging, happened to pull over to the side, hold on a sec, chaps, I've just got to do something, you know, and talking money and weight. It never stops. Christmas Day, the only day off of the year, but I love it.
Superb. Let's assess your 2022 at Nielsen Boxing. So I saw the Instagram post you guys put out the other day. 12 shows, 5 venues and 3 live TV channels. I mean, I suppose you would call that a pretty successful year by all accounts.
Oh, 100%. It feels like the norm now, doing the kind of shows with the kind of production and the number of shows that we did last year. But, you know, it was only a few years ago, pre-COVID, we were a handful of shows a year with big aspirations. COVID, we were just starting to get going, sort of put the brakes on it, and then we come out of that full throttle, like I said. So, yeah, I'd say a pretty successful year. You know, when we look at that, like the Instagram post you mentioned, when we put it down on paper like that, and you actually put those numbers, you think, yeah, that's a good year. And we just got in a roll. I mean, I could have kept going and doing more and more shows and stuff, and people were having to just sort of curb me a little bit because I can't be doing a show every weekend. You know, we've all got families and wives and stuff, and should forget what I'm looking, what it looked like on at some stage. But yeah, it was a really successful year. Big plans moving forward, but you know, 2022 is a big tick for us.
Yeah. Best fight and best fighter are the two ones I want to talk to you about. So we'll start with the best fight. I can remember a couple of good ones myself, but I mean, you've seen every single one. So you're the man. Best fight of the year for yourself out of your stable and your shows?
Well, I'd say Jordan Dujon, Jack Martin, Southern Area fight, your call. Proper, toe-to-toe. I think it was 96, 94, but it was close. Leighton's looking after the other corner. You know, he comes in and goes, you know, it could have gone either way. But I love that fight. I say it a lot. You know, I'm a fight fan first and foremost. I say that a lot. And I am. I just love sitting there. I get the best seat in the house at ringside. Two guys giving everything. Both of them had, you know, really good records, stoppages in recent fights. Didn't think it would go the distance. Half the people were saying Martin was going to win this. Half the people were saying Dujon's got this hands down. It's a big fight for both of them and leading on to big things for the winner. So there's a lot on the line. And I love that fight. You know, and, you know, it's a Southern Area title fight at your call. A lot of non-boxing people wouldn't know who these people are yet because they're not at the highest level yet. But, you know, we're fortunate to see fights like that on our shows, sat at ringside. That was a cracker. Love that fight.
Yeah, kind of your pick for your best fighter of last year?
My breakout fighter, I like to say, is probably my guy, Johnny Ward. Super middle, knocks out everyone. No one wants to fight him. We nearly got him a Southern Area fight in only his, would have been his fifth fight, but it was a bit too short notice. It never really happened for one reason or another. But nobody wants to fight him. And I'm not going to mention any of the names, but there are other people out there who are saying, well, I've got a title fight, can't get anyone to fight me. We'll have to fight, you know, foreigners. Johnny Ward's been offering, we've been offering you to fight. And they're saying, nah, not quite ready for him yet. Nobody will fight him. So he's going to probably be fast-tracked. He's ready. He's made for TV. He's knocking everyone out. I mean, he's 5-0, 3 KOs. His last fight would have been a stoppage, but it's a technical draw because of a cut. But it was just a matter of time. And this guy can bang, you know, trained by Roger Lee, Andy Lee's brother. So he's got, you know, come from good stock there, being looked after. And this year, I think 2023 is titles for him. The record doesn't probably do him justice, but I think we're going to probably fast track him because it's no benefit in him, you know, and he's knocking over journeymen who don't get knocked over. So there's no benefit in him fighting people with losing records, getting another win, getting 8-0, 9-0. What's the point? So we just want to get straight in. So we want to get more rounds. And what Johnny always says is, we said, right, we're going to stick this guy in with you. Hopefully he's going to give you more rounds so you can just get the rounds, get the experience up. He says, I could do more rounds. It's just they can't. Sums him up.
Let's talk about 2023. So obviously I mentioned your 12 shows. Do you kind of set, I know you'll have plans in place, but do you set a target number of shows before? I know, like you said, you'd love to churn them out every week, but it is obviously quality over quantity. And that's, I suppose, what's been a big thing for you this year, why you've had so many good shows. So do you kind of target a number of shows, or do you not get into that sort of stuff?
Well, at the beginning of 2022, we wanted to have half a dozen really good shows. We ended up with 12. What we do is we just take the opportunities as they come. I think we've got 6 or 7 dates already confirmed in. That will probably end up with about a dozen. I don't think any more than that is going to be feasible with availability of opponents, availability of boxers. You know, we've got a big stable. And as we've mentioned before, we work with all the other promoters, all the other managers. And so we've got access to all of the boxers. I think probably a dozen is a good number. It may be a couple more. It won't be too many more. And we just want to concentrate on the quality. You know, we want to fill the cards up with really good fights. One thing we are doing slightly different this year is we're spinning off and doing some of our normal quality, high quality cards, like in the York Hall that you've seen with a, you know, good depth of 50-50 fights and some title fights. But we're also doing what we call prospect cards. So we're going to have Fight Town Prospects as a separate brand. So that card is going to be full of like 3-0, 4-0 guys. And they're going to have their own show, if you like. A bit like, I suppose, Matchroom did with their next gen, you know, and you'll probably have some smaller titles on that. But we're going to sort of intersperse those in some of the bigger shows.
Yeah. Do you feel for 2023, because again, if you're to look at the shows you had and kind of locationally where they are, do you kind of feel you're carrying the flag a bit for certain boxing deprived areas, if you will? Yeah. But in 2023, you'll be bringing more shows to areas that we don't associate with boxing. It's obvious, you know, it's easy for us to go your Newcastles, your Sheffields, obviously your Londons. Yeah. You'll kind of bring it to places. Yeah. Like I said, carrying the flag for some of these places that are a bit deprived of boxing.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Swindon, you know, the Fight Town brand came from Swindon because it just had such a history of it. And we sort of shared that around. You know, Gloucester, Bracknell, Oxford, not traditionally known for boxing, but we're bringing shows to those areas. And then we're thrown in London, then we're thrown in Liverpool, because we don't want to just be this little Southwest promoter of maybe years ago. We're way past that now. And you still get some of these bigger, busier promoters, but they're still putting the same shows on in the hotel on a Sunday afternoon, week after week, month after month or whatever. And they may have more shows than us, but we want to just, you know, we don't want to just sort of ring fence ourselves into some of these smaller areas. But we don't also just want to target on that, you know, Manchester, Newcastle. We want to, you know, there's an appetite for boxing in all of these towns. Like we said, Swindon, Bracknell, Gloucester. Who'd have thought you could have put a really good quality professional show on in these towns, but we've done it. And certainly doing that again this year. I mean, we've got, we've got London, we've got Swindon, we've got Gloucester. We'll have another Oxford. We're doing Harrow for the first time for a different location to York Hall for one of our prospect cards. That's already booked in. And there's going to be more locations as well as the year goes on.
To the wider scale, we had some ups, we had some downs last year. I suppose this is kind of a broad question. But do you think boxing walked away from 2022 in a better or worse place?
I'd say better. People have short memories, and you know, I remember, I mean, I say this, you know, you're a lot younger than me, and I remember the bad times of, say, the 90s after the Nigel Benn and Eubank and the, you know, the seniors all retired. There was this sort of period where promotion was all fragmented on Sky Sports. There was 3 or 4 different promoters. They weren't great fights and stuff. So even with the problems that boxing had last year, it's in a far better state than it was 10 years ago. And people have short memories. You know, there's always the Benn and Eubank Jr. fiasco, which I don't think anyone thinks was handled very well. And that just left a bad taste, and it was mainstream news and everyone spoke about it. But within a couple of weeks, you had Clarissa Shields and Savannah Marshall on an all-female card. And what a blinder of a show that was. And everyone seemed to forget about it. So, you know, there's been some bad, some ups and downs, but in an industry which generates tens and tens of millions of pounds, has thousands of people involved in it, you know, there's over 1,000 registered boxers in the UK. Sometimes somebody's going to get it wrong sometimes. But overall, we're in far better shape than we started the year, I'd say.
Yeah. It looks like we're going to be in for a big year, kind of from what we know is penciled in and talk around fights that are, say, verbally agreed. We know that's kind of a loose term at times in boxing. But what needs to be changed in 2023, be it over here, across the pond, just in general, I suppose, what needs to be changed, would you say, if you could pinpoint one thing?
Well, I think the big issue of the moment is the drug testing. I think on the positives we've got, you know, Ben Shalom with boxing now on Sky, he's really getting going on that, which is sort of, you know, Eddie Hearn's sort of gone a bit global. Ben Shalom seems to have filled the void. Frank Warren's taken probably number one spot in the UK again for the moment. So that's all really good and really healthy. But as I said, as I touched on, the negative is the drug testing. It seems we don't seem to have that right. The Ben Eubank sort of brought all that to the fore, didn't it? That the process isn't quite right. It needs to be. And all the people who have been involved in boxing for a long time, I think, are all in agreement. Systems and the processes and the do's and the don'ts. You know, the fight was going to go on. Ward hadn't said anything. There was two positive tests, allegedly. You know, we'll soon find out, I suppose. But it's just all a bit of a mess. So that needs to be tidied up. I mean, it's we say that we're very good at criticising over here in the UK, aren't we? But still, even if with its current status and needing tidying up, it's still far better than the majority of countries. And if you think UK and the US are the two biggest boxing countries in the UK, it's definitely a mess in America, isn't it? You can get banned in one state and fight in another, and there's no national body to do it. So we criticise the UK system, but it's far better than anywhere else still. But, yeah. You know, I think, yeah, there's one thing that could be improved. It's the open process, situation, procedures, whatever.
Yeah. On a lighter note, your favourite moment from last year?
Well, I was at AJ and Usyk in Jeddah. So I was at ringside to watch the meltdown and stuff like that. So fascinating to watch, to be a part of it. So I really enjoyed that whole process. For me, on a personal note, as I say, I get to see boxing like yourself, Oscar. I'm very privileged to see the sport I love on a regular basis. But, you know, that was great for me. I took my boy with me, you know, and it was just a whole great experience. And, you know, the millions that the heavyweight boxing is generating at the moment shows there's still a taste for it. You know, what did 150 or 1,000 see Tyson Fury last year? You know, it's going to be a monster year, isn't it? 2023. Again, I think Fury, Usyk, maybe Fury, AJ body, and who knows. But that was a highlight for me, taking my boy to AJ Usyk and seeing it all close up in Jeddah.
Yeah, still kind of unbelievable when I watch it now that kind of even happened. Mark, cheers for your time. Just one more thing. Have you got kind of a message for boxing fans, I suppose, as we head into, like what I said at the start, is fingers crossed, a massive year?
Yeah, well, stick watching the Fight Town brand. It's taken over. I mean, we're back out 3rd of March, your call, British title fight, Southern area fights. Then we're back out 11th of March in Gloucester a week later with English and a lot of prospects on that. You know, doing a Harrow show in April for the first time. You know, we've got some really, really big plans. We're the momentum's going with us now. Everyone knows who we are. We're working with everyone. All the promoters are happy working with us. The managers are working with us, which just gives us more choice. So we can sit there and there's always the fights that you want to see on your cards and there's fights you're able to organise and get on your cards. But the fights we want to see, we can get on now because we've got the momentum, we've got the production and the product and the boxers want to fight. With the money's being generated, we can pay the purses. You know, we're not losing any fights. We can't afford to pay the money. So we can sit there and say, well, I'd like to see him versus him and him versus him. And it's happening now. You know, we've got a British title fight on. You know, that's our first big title fight. But, you know, we've done Commonwealth, you know, IBF International, Southern Areas, English. So, you know, now we've got our first British title fight. So 2022 is a lot of firsts for us. There's, you know, first Oxford show in 60 years on a rooftop in Liverpool, in the Shankly Hotel. York Hall. Boxers say it's an iconic venue and all, it's on their list to fight there. As a promoter, I promoted at York Hall. that's such a big deal. So it's a lot of firsts for us in 2022, and I think 2023 is going to have an awful lot of firsts as well for us.
I'm going to share something with you that might put me in a very negative light, yeah.
Relationships are not my forte.
See if someone grabbed up my wife and saying, completely different ballgame.
I'll walk away from here, and this has been like a therapy session.